Hi guys, my name is Pavan and I welcome you all towards my YouTube channel. So guys, this is going to be the part 2 video on how you're supposed to prepare for Christ University interview. So all the questions which I'm going to discuss is going to be the campus based interview questions. Regardless of whichever college you apply, whether it is Christ University or Fitz St. Joseph or any kind of university, there are a fixed set of campus based questions which normally an interviewer asks. So it's mainly asked to understand about the individual potential which each student has, plus what are their background knowledge or what are their background understanding about the campus. So as being said that, let's get started without further delay. And I would also like to tell you, in case if you have not watched the part 1 video, kindly watch it and then come back to this video, as such you'll get a clear picture on how you're supposed to channelize and put up your thoughts while speaking out your answers. So now we're going to focus on 9 important campus based interview questions, and there are a few important tips which I would like to give you along with your preparation. First one is record your voice, record yourself on how you're presenting the content, have more mocks with your friends, relatives or whoever it is, because the more number of mocks you have, your confidence level will be increasing. The third important tip is, while you're preparing answers for these set of questions, do not prepare as paragraph, prepare as pointers. As such, your communication will be much more natural, or else the interviewer will feel it as that you're telling out the answer in much more artificial way. So make sure that you give it through natural form. It happens only through practice, and have constant practice through mirror. Look at the mirror and then tell out your answers. As such, you'll be getting your confidence will be boosting at each level. So these are the few important tips. So now let's look into the next set of questions which you're supposed to prepare, and plus what is the main essence of interviewer asking those kind of set of questions. So the first question is, what can you contribute to a college campus? So why normally an interviewer asks this question is that to check whether you are truly interested in their college, and they wanted to know whether what you can bring up to the campus. Because of you having an important asset to a college, what is the important benefit the university is going to get? So over here you can talk about what you have learned about the college and why you feel it's right place for you. So you can tell out about the extracurricular activities, you can tell it how you're going to contribute and how you're going to help the university in different means, and how you're going to help up your peer group. You can just mention it in all other aspects. That can suffice for that first question. For the second question is about what do you want to do after graduating from college. So make sure that it comes as, be honest in this answer. So what do you want to do after you're graduating? Tell it out something which is related to the course which you have been opted for. And a third question is, if you could change one thing about your school or college, what would it be? The answer is, be very creative. So whenever you're putting out your answer, be very creative. It is basically to check whether you are a careful thinker, plus what are your observations, plus what kind of problems are you finding out, and what kind of solutions you would like to put it up. So all these aspects are basically judged in these set of questions. So the next question is, what are you interested in this college? So normally an interviewer asks this particular kind of question. It is basically to check whether the candidate has a background knowledge about that particular kind of campus. So what you can do, you can talk about the major academic program as well as the cultural values of the universities. You can even speak about the CSA, that is Center for Social Action, which is basically supporting the society through different means, or even speak about the Students' Council. You can tell that all these factors has basically encouraged you to be part of this campus. You can even speak about the faculty support, internship and recruitment facilities provided by the campus. So all these are the external factors which you can mention it out even in your answer, and have a constant practice in that. And one more tip which I would like to give you is that you can refer to the website at www.christuniversity.in. There you can see a list of cultural activities as well as other aspects provided by the university to the students. So while you're preparing your answer, you can cover up all those important aspects and then you can put it up as an answer. Your fifth question is, why do you want to major in dash course? So normally an interviewer asks this question, it is basically to make sure that, to check whether this candidate has a solid background knowledge about the course which you have applied for. For example, if you have applied for BCom International Finance, and International Finance is a major course which you have been applied, or you're trying to specialize in that particular course. So they want to know what well-defined answer or what well is your depth knowledge about that particular field. So a simple tip which I would like to give you is that, type out a course name in the Google along with Christ University, you'll get a description about that particular course. So take out the important key points from it and then you can tell out the answer for this particular question. Your sixth question is, what are your academic strengths? So guys, while telling out this answer, make sure that you put in a solid, correct structure. Just don't tell that I'm good in English or I'm good in communication. For example, you can just make sure that you give it with a proper narrative. So as I said earlier, just one point answers cannot be sufficient while you go for any kind of interview. As I said in the previous video too, if I'm asking your strength as well as your weakness, just don't tell that you are very good in decision making skills or communication skills. I want to hear what are your skills which you have been apted out of it, where have you applied out of it, and what are the benefits you have been got out of it. So make sure that similar way you apply even for that concept in this particular question. While speaking about your academic strength, you can tell, for example, if you are an excellent writer, you can tell that how has your writing skills helped you to excel in different field in your college, and how you have done many publications and how you have got many awards because of that. You can even just tell out those factors relating with the proper examples. So this suffices the next set of important questions. So guys, the seventh question is, what are your academic weakness and how are you trying to overcome it? See, normally in an interview asks this particular question. It is basically to analyze you and to see on how you are working on your limitations or you're working on your weakness. So I've seen that some students, when I conduct mock interview, they tell that they do not have any kind of weakness. And the interviewer know very clearly that you're blushing, because any person has, they have one or other kind of weakness. So what you can tell that, for example, if this question was asked to me, I would have been told that I'm much more detail oriented. As such, I just take much time while covering up each concept. As such, I lose out more time. But I'm trying to overcome it by having a fixed time management skills, which I keep out a certain time for completing out each task. As such, I'm trying to overcome this particular weakness. See guys, an important tip which I would like to tell you is that whenever you're telling out your weakness, you should tell a proper solution towards it, and there must be no cross question. And if the interviewer wastes much time in your strength and weakness, they wouldn't be asking important essential other questions. As such, you may lose out your marks. So it's very important you analyze your weakness and tell a proper structured answer for it. And the eighth question is, whom do you admire the most and why? See, normally this question is asked to basically understand on whom do you admire, what are you more passionate about, what has basically motivated and empowered you. So just don't tell as one word answer. For example, you can just don't tell it as Swami Vivekananda motivated you. If you're telling about Swami Vivekananda, tell a beautiful quote about him and tell him why that particular quote has basically inspired you. Why do you feel that you have to work for a change in the society? Speaking to different aspect, as I said, you can give a small narrative. It should not be so long, but a small short description in which the interview feel much more impressed and get connected. The ninth question is, what do you expect to be doing 10 years from now or 5 years from now? Or normally, if this question is asked from 10 years from now, it's very important that institutions want to see students who are motivated and to achieve their goals. What are they trying to work on their passion, and what do they really want to be in the future aspect? So that's the reason normally in interview asks this particular kind of question. So you can tell that you want to become a CEO of a company, CFO of a company, or you want to build up your own corporate empire, and give a much more practical example with a small short narrative. See, whenever I say about narrative, right, that story gets connected towards the interviewer. As such, there is a form of bonding which is created, and then the interviewer feels that, okay, this person is much more goal-oriented, much more passionate in his field. So these are the set of important campus-based interview questions which I've just introduced to you guys. So make sure that you have a constant practice. Make sure that you write as pointers and prepare it continuously. And if you want mock interviews, you can get in touch with me. My Insta ID is pavan.ss, and if you want, you can even mail me regarding mock interviews. Or else, if you are not able to conduct a mock interview with me because if I'm occupied with many other students, if I'm not able to do it, what you guys can do is that constantly practice with your friends, relatives, whoever, if possible. Just have more mocks. The more mocks you have, that much your confidence level will be increasing. And I get flooded with mock interviews every day. Normally it takes 15 mock interviews every day I just normally conduct for students. So yes, I'm just telling out one thing. So many of them are taking up mocks. Try evolving and learn from your mistakes. That's the main essence of taking mocks. So have mock as much time as possible with your friends, relatives, and get a proper constructive feedback. Okay, so in the next video, we'll be discussing on how you're supposed to prepare for Christ University interview-based questions, the campus-based interview-based question of the Christ University. That we'll be discussing in much depth in the part 3 video. So if you do like this video, please do like it, share it, and subscribe. And thank you so much for all your support. Goodbye.